So the question from Reddit today is that how do we solve this equation by factoring? Notice here we have sine squared minus 4 sine x plus 3 is equal to 0. The key here is here we have the squared, here is the first power, and there's no sine here, right? So this is actually a quadratic equation in terms of sine. So you can take a look right here. If today I ask you t squared minus 4t plus 3 equal to 0, how would you factor this? You can do the tic-tac-toe method. Check this out. Go ahead and draw the tic-tac-toe boxes like this. You ask yourself what times 12 give you t squared, and the answer for that is t and t. And then you come here, you ask yourself what times 12 give you positive 3, and together they will add up to negative 4. And the answer for that is negative 1 and negative 3. And do this, you can double check. This times this, you get negative 3t. And this times that, you get negative t. Together, we do end up with negative 4t. So the factoring is t minus 1. You go across for the answer. T minus 1 times t minus 3. And that's equal to 0. And then you can continue from here. So t is equal to 1, t is equal to 3. But this is the factoring. And if you would like to see more examples on this, I will have a link in the description for you. So for this right here, we can do the same thing. Go ahead and draw the tic-tac-toe boxes right away. And we just have to do what? Sine and sine. Because sine x times sine x will give us sine x squared. And right here, let's use minus 1 and minus 3. And now let's cross multiply to check. This times this gives us negative 3 sine x. And this times this gives us negative sine x. Together, we do end up with negative 4 sine x, so that means we have the correct combination. Therefore, the answer, well, the factoring is sine x minus 1 times sine x minus 3. So that's the main question, how do we factor this quadratic equation in terms of sine? But let's solve this trig equation, of course. So let's go ahead and put down this right here being equal to 0. So the same thing like what we did right here, right? And to continue right here, you put first sine x minus 1 equal to 0, and the other one sine x minus 3 equal to 0. This gives us sine x is equal to 1. And this right here gives us sine x equals 3. But what's the maximum value of sine? It's just at 1, right? So this right here, it's impossible. But in fact, you have complex solutions for this. So I will just say, no real solutions. If you want to see how to solve sine x equal to 2, you can check out my other video for it. But that will be more for like complex analysis. So in your precalculus or trig class, you just say, no answer for this right here, and you're good to go. But for this right here, sine of what angle will give you 1, and the angle is from 0 to 2 pi? The answer is pi over 2, and that's the only one. X is equal to pi over 2. So just real quick, let's review the unit circle. All right, we are looking for sine x equal to 1. So on the unit circle, like this, sine is the y value on the unit circle. Where is the y value equal to 1? Right here. This coordinate is 0, 1, and this gives you the sine value. The cosine value here will be 0, and you know this right here is 0. This right here is pi over 2, which is 90 degrees, and this right here is pi, and this right here is 3 pi over 2. Anyway, pi over 2 is the answer. That's it.